they rose to fight again. I soon realized that only by taking into my own dagger the sands that possessed them could try liberate them from their monstrous lived death.
Now, finish it!
I'll start the story from here next time. You think me mad. I can see it by the look in your eyes. You think my story is impossible. Perhaps I am mad. Who would not be driven mad by horrors such as I have lived? But I assure you, every word is true. The guest rooms, where my father, all our entourage, and I should have passed the night, lay cold and silent. The sands of time had swept through, stealing life and warmth from everything they touched. And I, who unleashed the cataclysm, had been spared. Were there others like me, who yet clung to life, hiding in fear among the ruins? It did not seem so.
Come back!
Had I really seen her? Or had my senses given way under the burden of horrors too great to bear and conjured up a phantom? Either way, I could not rest until I had found her again. I discovered that when I had collected enough sand, the dagger gained the power to stop time. Not for me, but for the enemy I struck. I'll start the story from here next time. Whence came these visions that assaulted me thus like fever dreams? Each time I awoke feeling drained and beaten. And each time, what I had seen came to pass. As if the sands of time were giving me a glimpse into my own future.
Hello? Is anyone there? I have a feeling I'm not in Azad anymore. Water.
Give me the dagger.
Who are you?
I am Farah, the daughter of the Maharaja from whom you stole it. This is your doing.
I saw my father turn to sand.
And we will share his fate if you do not give me the dagger to undo what you have done.
Your traitorous vizier used the same words. From now on, I trust no one but myself. Run! Go back to the reception hall. Wait for me there. Go! Ah!